It's time to talk about boundaries. It's time to get real about letting go of control. Let's do this. It's a very short list. What you have responsibility for. Can you guess what it is? You got it. It's you. You, yourself, and you. That is the short list of what you are responsible for in your life. Well, hi there, I'm Dawn of Living by Heart, where we inspire you to connect more deeply with God and your family. I am here to give it to you straight today, and we are talking about letting go of control. And probably better than that, we are talking about freedom and what life-changing joy and peace and hope result when we are able to let go of control. So let's dig into it. When people talk about letting go of control, I think it's hard to realize what are we actually letting go of. A lot of times I think we don't realize that we're actually being very controlling. And so I think first of all, it's hard for us to recognize like, well, what does it mean to be controlling? When we are in a controlling place, what we are trying to control is actually the outcome. So if it's our kids and we want them to get good grades, you know, one way that we would be controlling would be perhaps to nag them about doing their homework or to maybe even write their papers for them. Believe it or not, I had a classmate in high school whose mother did that for him, and I've often wondered if that served him well. So letting go of control is the opposite of that, where we might say to ourselves, well, this is outside the realm of my responsibility, and so letting go of control in this situation means that I'm letting go of the outcome, which is the grade that my child receives in this class, and therefore I have to make peace with whichever grade he or she receives. And so we let go of the outcome because we have a healthy understanding of what it is that we can actually control. If you can grasp this truth of what you are actually responsible for in your life, your whole decision-making platform changes. You begin to have revelation around boundaries you need to set, and your life becomes a whole lot more peaceful because you're living within the realm of your responsibility. People always say, well, what about my kids? It's this constant kind of process of launching and letting go of outcomes as they get their sea legs on, as I like to say. So of course, when they're young, we give them the square meal with all of the vegetables, but as they get older and enter like middle school and high school, the idea would be, can we let go of control and empower them to make good choices? But if we're controlling them and, you know, emptying the house of all sugar because we just have absolutely no faith that they're gonna figure this out and we wanna control the situation, this is when we get into trouble, because what kids will do is then they will, of course, when they have access to that item, then they will go hog wild oftentimes, right? We hear about kids who go off to college and they just have zero skills about how to manage it themselves because they've been controlled during their childhood. And then when they're launched into young adulthood, they really don't have the skills to kind of decide for themselves, how do I want my life to look? So the beauty of letting go of control and letting go of outcomes is it really allows you as a parent to begin to pose a question to your kids. And so, for example, let's go with the sugar. You might educate them on the truth about sugar and how it is a cancer-causing agent. It's something that leads to disease. It causes, you know, insulin resistance and lots of health issues. Now, we're not, of course, sharing this in like a shaming way. I just feel like I need to clarify. We are just educating, making sure that they know the truth about it, and then teaching them how to have moderation. We let them have too much candy sometimes so that they can decide, ooh, did I like how that felt or not? And then they begin to have these experiences under your roof where they get to exercise some of their empowerment to make healthy choices or unhealthy ones and experience those consequences. This is such a healthy exercise for us as people. And of course, I'm referring mostly to the parent-child relationship, but there are so many ways that the experience of letting go of control can show up. What we have to make peace with then is letting go of the outcome, where we say to ourselves, can we live with the fact that their teacher is gonna say, oh, you don't have your notebook and we can't move forward with this assignment? Yes, we can let that go because it's not in our responsibility. And so again, going back to what we're responsible for, it is you. You, yourself, and you. That is it. One thing that I've noticed about Jesus in the scriptures, and I just love that God included this, is that he asked people if they wanted to be healed. He did not take anyone's ability to choose to be responsible for themselves. He did not just force himself on anyone. He would say to them, "Do you want to be healed?" And they would have to actually say, "Yes, that's what I want." They would have to give their permission to the King of Kings for him to touch their life. And I just think that's amazing because he's a God of, I guess he's very gentlemanly, right? He does not force himself, and he lets us choose for ourselves. And the ultimate example of, you know, letting go of control is when he gave us the key. The whole gospel story is a ginormous story of God letting go of control and allowing us to choose whether we want to follow him or not. And so taking a note from him, we too can be sure that we don't absorb a lack of responsibility around us. If you're anything like me, I tend to gravitate and I find all of the responsibility and I put it on myself. I don't know about you guys. And so it's been a lifelong process of realizing, oh my goodness, that's actually not a very healthy sense of boundaries. I'm just responsible for myself. It's perfectly okay for me to say no, or maybe later, or it doesn't work this time. To let people to be responsible for themselves is the most loving act we can do. Because of course, when our children leave our home, the last thing that we want them to do is to make others around them responsible for themselves. You know, to expect that others are gonna meet their needs at the drop of a hat. And so really, when I'm struggling with saying no, I fast forward in my mind to them being 25 years old, maybe living with roommates, or maybe they're interacting with another family at their home for dinner. And if I am picturing them, you know, expecting other people to do things that they are responsible for, I would be sick. I would be so sad. And I would feel like I have failed in my role as a parent, which is to empower my kids to embrace their God-given responsibility and to walk it out. And of course, they're gonna make mistakes. I make mistakes. And so there's grace in the midst of that. I just want to make sure that they're empowered, that they know that they have what it takes to make those healthy choices, to balance, you know, whether it's their diet intake, their media intake, how they do their homework, all of that. There's coaching along the way, but not a taking on of what isn't mine to own. And when you live this way, there is a lightness. I am telling you, whew, the peace that I feel on the days when I truly, truly know and believe to the seat of my soul that I am just responsible for myself and that all I can really do is love and influence others, but I can't control them. I want to hear how you are letting go of control this week and what outcomes you're letting go of and how you might implement this idea of just being responsible for you, yourself, and you. And we're gonna be talking more in future weeks about boundaries and what it looks like in practical terms. And so I invite you to tune in and be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you don't miss any of those videos, and blessings on your week.